everyone. I am Angel Anasoni from St. Xavier's UP School. Now, here to talk about the present crisis. The words of Alice Mosia is an American historian and author. Every day may not be good, but there is something good in every day. Life is a journey. We may find difficulties, challenges, problems in this life. It may come in different shape and size. Man has inherent power and capacity to overcome the problems and challenges. Here, what is needed is to make use of capacity. What we have to face the challenges to achieve the success. We are away from classroom, teachers and friends. But one door is closed, many bases are open before us. Our life is connected to the fact that challenges bring courage to overcome the situation. As we experience the crisis, it's the possibility to make use of it. Life in the time of Corona is the unforgettable lesson for all of us. We all maintain a greater distance, but this distance brings a closer relationship among the family members. Now our schools are closed, but thousands of homeschool are open. Words of Roy T. Bennett. Instead of worrying about what we cannot control, shift your energy to what we can create. It's the time for empower. Don't forget, everything may not be good, but there is something good in everything. Thank you.
Hi teachers and my friends, I am Pranav Krishna presenting you some interesting proverbs. Do you like to hear proverbs? The first one is, honesty is the best policy. Second one is, a leopard never changes his spot. Third one is, all the glitters are not gold. Fourth one is, beauty is the eye of the beholder. Fifth one is, the grass isn't always greener on the other side. Sixth one is, never judge a book by its cover. Seventh one is, actions speak louder than words. Eighth one is, beauty is skin deep. Ninth one is, good things come to those who wait. Tenth one is, a picture is worth 1,000 words. Thank you.
Impact of COVID-19 on education. The impact of pandemic COVID-19 is observed in every sector around the world. The education sector of India as well as world are badly affected by this. However, impact of COVID-19 on education has few positive outcomes apart from the many negative aspects of this pandemic. Positive impact of COVID-19. COVID-19 has accelerated adoption of digital technologies of education. Educational institutions moved towards blended mode of learning. It encouraged all teachers and students to become more technology savvy. The pandemic situation induced people to learn and use digital technology and resulted in increasing digital literacy. Negative impact of COVID-19. Education sector has suffered a lot due to of the outbreak of COVID-19. It has created many negative impacts on education. Classes have been suspended and exams at different levels postponed. Admission process got postponed due to COVID-19. Construction. The year 2020 is going to be most remarkable period of 21st century with millions of death all over the world and degraded economy of countries what are worst affected. Educator sector also one of the most sector in this pandemic time. Regular hand washing and social distancing or isolation is what we can do. Thank you.
Be careful, little head, what you think. Be careful, little head, what you think. There's a God up above watching over you and me. Be careful, little head, what you think. Be careful, little eyes, what you see. Be careful, little eyes, what you see. There's a God up above watching over you and me. Be careful, little eyes, what you see. Be careful, little ears, what you hear. Be careful, little ears, what you hear. There's a God up above watching over you and me. Be careful, little ears, what you hear. Be careful, little nose, what you smell. Be careful, little nose, what you smell. There's a God up above watching over you and me. Be careful, little nose, what you smell. Be careful, little mouth, what you speak. Be careful, little mouth, what you speak. There's a God up above watching over you and me. Be careful, little mouth, what you speak. Be careful, little head, what you love. Be careful, little head, what you love. There's a God up above watching over you and me. Be careful, little heart, what you love. Be careful, little hands, what you do. Be careful, little hands, what you do. There's a God up above watching over you and me. Be careful, little hands, what you do. Be careful, little legs, where you go. Be careful, little legs, where you go. There's a God up above watching over you and me. Be careful, little legs, where you go. Be careful, little heart, what you think. Be careful, little eyes, what you see. Be careful, little ears, what you hear.
Never to give up. One day, a farmer's donkey fell down into a well. The animal cried piteously for hours as the farmer tried to figure out what to do. Finally, he decided the animal was old and the well needed to be covered up anyway. It just was worth it to retrieve the donkey. He invited all his neighbors to come over and help him. They all grabbed a shovel and began to shovel dirt into the well. At first, the donkey realized what was happening and cried herbily. Then, to everyone's amazement, he quieted down. A few shovel loads later, the farmer finally looked down the well and was astonished at what he saw. With every shovel of dirt that fell on his back, the donkey was doing something amazing. He would shake it off and take a step up. As the farmer's neighbors continued to shovel dirt on top of the animal, he would shake it off and take a step up. But soon, everyone was amazed as the donkey stepped up over the edge of the well and stood off. Moral: life is going to shovel dirt on you all kinds of dirt. The trick is to not to get bogged down by it. We can get out of the deepest wells by not stopping and by never giving up. Shake it off and take a step up. Thank you.
I am Karthikesh Krishna. I am studying in 6B. The road not taken. This well-known poem is about making choices and the choices that shape us. Robert Frost is an American poet who writes simply, but insightfully about common ordinary experiences. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry, I could not travel both. And be one traveler long I stood, and looked down one as far as I could, to where it bent in the underground. Then took the other just as far, and having perhaps the better claim, because it was grassy and wanted wear, thought as for that the passing there had warned them really about the same. And both that morning equally lay in leaves, no step had trodden black. Oh, I kept the fast for another day, yet knowing how well it's on today. I doubted if I should ever come back. I shall be telling this with a sigh, somewhere ages and ages hence. Two roads diverged in a wood, and sorry, I could not travel both. And I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. Robert Frost, thank you.
Hello, my dear friends. I am Abel Tichako. Do you like to hear story? Yes. Never challenge the nature. Once an eagle came flying and sat on the branch of a tree that stood by a pool. At that time, a tortoise was basking on the bank of the pool. He was very dissatisfied with his life of the ground. He wanted to fly in the air like birds. So he wished the eagle and said, "Sir, I have to make a request." The eagle asked what it is. The tortoise said, "Please teach me how to fly. I have fed up my life on ground." The eagle advised the tortoise not to go against the rule of nature, as he hasn't wings to fly. But the tortoise didn't listen to him. Requested so hard that the eagle to agree to touch him fly. So the eagle picked up the tortoise high his claws and flew high in the sky. The tortoise felt puffed up. Suddenly the eagle let him go. Down came the tortoise to far head long on a rock and dashed it into pieces. Thank you.
Hi friends, I am Shinoy Joseph, studying in St. Xavier's Pacha. Today I am going to recite one of the famous poem, Daffodils, by the William Wordsworth. William Wordsworth, one of the famous romantic poet, Daffodils is a masterpiece work of the Wordsworth. He is also known as a poet of nature. Hear the ways. I wandered lonely as a cloud, a float on higher parts and hills. When all at once I saw the crowd, a host of golden daffodils. Beside the lake, beneath the trees, fluttering and danced in the breeze. Continuing as the star that shine and twinkle on the Milky Way. The stretch in the never-ending line along the margin of the bay. 10,000 say, I at a glance tossed their head and spread down. They were beside the dance, but they out with the sparkly way in the game. A poet could not but be gay in such a jocund company. I gaze and gaze, but the little thought what wealth to me art wrote.